too late to tell Daddy the truth.
Truth about what?
The truth. The truth is everything that I hold dear is hanging by a thread. The secrets I'm living with could destroy me and everyone I love. And secrets have such a nasty way of coming out.
That should be your husband now.
Al, it's Gregory. You ready or you want me to wait downstairs?
You set me up.
Because I know it's the only way to get you off the fence. Now, you either leave your hubby or I tell him all about us.
Del didn't understand how much in love I was with my husband. Like all the others, this affair was born out of loneliness and spite. To get back at Gregory for still not wanting me when he was the only man I had ever wanted. But Del never got the chance to tell my husband.
Oh, my God, when? Yeah, I'll be right there. Del's been shot.
Everybody out!
I'm sorry. There was just too much damage.
I'd dodged another bullet. Too bad Del wasn't as lucky. Gregory would never know. Or so I thought.
Olivia! Wake up!
Unfortunately, Del turned out to be more trouble dead than alive.
Were you and Del having an affair? Answer me! I saw you with him, Olivia, last night. Were you and he having an affair? Or are you in the habit of kissing a dead man's cold lips and telling him how much you love him?
Why would you even care? You haven't touched me in years. No one's lips are colder than yours.
Is everything all right in there?
I'll take her from here, Daddy. You get her some coffee, I'll find some dry clothes, and then you can both tell me what's going on this time.
As always, her father was the put-upon hero, and I was the wicked witch. We were a house divided. Caitlin adored her father and ignored me.
You know something, I wasn't going to do this, but until after the party, I bought you a little something. It's sitting up in my room on top of my dresser.
Thank you for the earrings. They're so beautiful. I love them.
Oh, good. You're welcome. Well, you know, you'll always be my little girl. And if I can make you happy, well, that makes me happy.
While Sean, our son, despised Gregory.
What do you want from me, Sean?
I want you to leave me alone. I don't want anything from you anymore.
But he was the apple of my eye.
Why do you put up with Dad? I mean it. How can you love someone that treats you like that? I don't believe you still love him. I can't change him being my father. But you can. You don't have to stay married to him.
It wasn't always this way. Your father was a truly wonderful man once. But things hadn't been wonderful between Gregory and me for a very long time.
Where are you going? Off to one of your cheap little girlfriends. It's all right for you to have as many affairs as you want, but God forbid I should even look at another
man. You did a lot more than look, my dear.
What is it that bothers you? The fact that he was your best friend, or that we did it right here in this house, on this sofa, on that rug, in your bed. Oh.
Thank you.
I thought Gregory was finally willing to give us another chance. But I thought wrong. You'd think it would get easier. But each time he ripped my heart out, it only hurt more. At least the tide was turning with Caitlin. My baby girl was in love.
I still remember what first love is like.
Sometimes I feel like I can fly. I'm so happy.
I remember waking up happy and going to bed happy and dreaming. Happy dreams are always magical. Enjoy it.
Why can't the feelings that we have for first love be a part of true love?
Maybe they are. Maybe my first love was my true love.
That your true love isn't Daddy?
Who says he isn't?
What happened?
I'm not sure I know. But I am sure that things will be better for you.
I know they will.
And I am so happy for you.
We'd never been closer, but the one thing that brought us together, Gregory was about to tear apart. He couldn't stand the thought of not being the only man in his daughter's life.
I was merely trying to protect my daughter from what is possibly a fortune-hunting gigolo out to fleece her of her inheritance.
Daddy, I don't believe you. He is not like that at all.
How do you know?
I just do.
Do you know anything about this boy?
I know that he is kind and sweet, and I can talk to him about anything, which is the way I used to feel about you.
But you are going to break her heart.
She will be happier in the long run.
Don't do this, Gregory.
So, he eliminated the competition.
Caitlin, are you all right?
Daddy!
What happened?
He broke up with me.
This time, he'd gone too far.
Proud of yourself.
And just what do you plan to be doing?
Oblivion is a great way to cope. I can't bear to see you hurt anyone anymore, Gregory. I just want to disappear.
It was one thing for Gregory to break my heart. I knew what I was getting into and went willingly. But to destroy our daughter's happiness without a twinge of regret, I felt so alone. But suddenly, I wasn't.
Excuse me. You should take it easy.
I'm fine. Really?
Why do I feel like I know you? Come and sit down. Tell me what is bothering you. It's a woman, isn't it?
Maybe I should get you out of here. See if we can get you home safely.
No. No, I'm not going home. I will go anywhere, but I am not going home.
Oh, kill the damn lights. Oh, please.
So, tell me about your husband.
He's devious and demanding and controlling. God forbid you should be a human being around him. Uh-uh. He won't allow that. Do you know what the saddest part of all of this is? I still love him. I know that you want to leave.
please don't. I don't think I could bear to be alone tonight.